Hi guys and welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to discover how to play Plants vs. Zombies on your PC. Here you can display it on screen. It takes almost no time to simply download and install Plants vs. Zombies so that we can enjoy playing your game on a Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to get started we need to open our main browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type anything, simply because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. After clicking on that link, we get to the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to this game Plants vs. Zombies on PC. As you can discover from here we access some pros of preferring using the emulator. Custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Plants vs. Zombies by simply clicking on the button Download Plants vs. Zombies on PC that you can see here in green. The step is clicking on this button. Of course, the download step starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the web browser to see the installation software much better. The installation software is straightforward. It consists of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path actually does. We merely simply click on it. And then we discover that we get here the path where the emulator will be placed. If we wish to change for better this directory we have got to click on that, browse, option. And therefore we opt for another folder and install the emulator wherever we like. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I pick install. At this moment, before you start the installation of this emulator, it is possible that it's going to show us several software packages to add on the computer. Since I do not want to have any of these software programs, I just simply press many times on the reject button. Great, the install starts and it is going to continue along with the download of these MB that are shown on this computer screen. As you download it, it might possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The data transfer rate will go faster or slower, determined by your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Today they are progressing extremely fast. The download is completed, so at this moment it continues on with the installation part. The installation needs more or less time based on the strength of your hard drive. The more robust it's actually, the faster the installation time and or vice versa. If we add together the download and software installation step it may take a considerably long time, so be patient. It is now finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been launched successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right then when it reaches the ending, the emulator will be started for the first time. Believe it or not the emulator is already launched, there for the first time. And therefore LD Store is by default launched, which is actually a kind of Google Play. That isn't the most correct option to install the video game, and I also will not propose it, considering the fact that quite possibly the LD Store installs an obsolete version of the game app. Allow me to present to you how you can set up the game by utilizing the Google Play. I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we will have to do is to visit desktop by simply clicking on this icon that I'm pointing out in green color. Before we continue on, as can be seen, it has created a couple of icons there on the PC desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer app icon is the only one we're concerned with. Every time we would like to start Plants vs. Zombies on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this particular icon and therefore launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon isn't about multiplayer or nearly anything like that. Basically, it is a software icon that we might quite likely never utilize. Let me make the next step, which is actually a must, and which is to access the Google Play Store. To achieve this we will go there to System Apps, we click on. And we are going to mouse click on Play Store. As can be seen the Google Play is presented. Here we are required to sign in. Currently the moment we are on this page, we must conduct the next phase which is imperative. So that we mouse click on Sign In. At present it announces, checking info. It can once in a while get stuck in, checking info, additionally it does not proceed. In that case, you should try to connect to your account after a few hours and it will surely probably be corrected. At present, we shall enter our email address and password. The email address must be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example, you can utilize the exact same email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I will provide my information and I'll come back immediately after I have accomplished it. Voila, information entered. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We would accept them all by simply clicking, I agree. Then, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected and it will make a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can use this feature if you prefer. We click on accept. By now Google Play is presented by default and instantly. In the event that the Google Play just isn't launched by default and you do not know how to start it yourself, I tell you how to do this. The crucial element is to proceed to the emulator desktop by clicking on this app icon noted in green color. Presently we navigate to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Well, I am here into Google Play. What we're going to perform now is browse here to search for apps and games. And then we are going to search for Plants vs. Zombies. So there we have it, we should click on the first result. On this page we access to the game. Let's click on right here on the install button that I'm just highlighting now in green color. This action will initiate the installation. Straight away it will download on your laptop or computer and install the Android game. It might take quite some time or perhaps it could also be very quick. It again all varies on our connection to the internet. This has just completed installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this option that I am showing in green, in order to use Plants vs. Zombies for the first time. I am presently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're going to click this fresh Plants vs. Zombies icon that was provided. That Android game is launched for the first time. There we end up with it. I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume of that emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we do not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the fullest, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This one is simply the first one. We mouse click on this app icon that I am basically pointing out in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, getting one border at the top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. If ever we like to appreciate the application in full screen, we mouse click on this application icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen mode. To escape the full screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And we'd by now play in normal display mode. At this point, I am ready to reveal you the computer keys mapping, which is definitely very useful. This strategy we will probably be ready to make use of the game application far more easily. The very first task is to mouse click this app icon. It's now time to make the recommended configurations. I can leave the normal configuration, though if you really want to improve that, you may very well do this without any problem. I take on this moment to comment that once in a while, when starting the Android game a black screen occurs. If this is like that and you experience the black display and this emulator is unable to launch, I comment a potential technique. We can hop on over to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator preferences, in the advanced option we have now numerous resolutions. This is the image resolution that we have now opted for automatically, therefore we must choose any of these additional resolutions, for instance this particular one listed below. We go for it and therefore click on save. It will tell us to restart your emulator and once rebooted, probably the emulator will get started and this black display screen will go away completely. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is absolutely in our language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is launched in the erroneous language, for example, in Japanese. And so to set it up in the right language we go there to the cogwheel. So right here within many other settings, we click the language drop down. We can determine the language we want. Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. When the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the Android game, the next time we run it, will also be in the specified language. Right now, you will find another aspect that we have to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email saying that a completely new equipment has been connected with our own Google account. It will likely check with us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Of course, we shouldn't be troubled, because the emulator is behaving like an Google Android device. And in order to identify which device is currently being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel, and we just click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model option. And now we discover that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it, guys. So much for the video user demo. I hope you appreciated it, especially that everyone found it informative. If that's so, bring it a nice thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, requests or ideas. Let them in the comment box down below. You can also leave comments on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams from time to time. You have it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click on any of the instructional videos that are appearing on the screen and see you in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye.